Hello. I'm here to talk about the residue of mathematics. Residue, that's the sticky stuff that's left over. What would you like the sticky stuff left over your course to be? What are the ideas and perceptions about mathematics, about themselves as learners of mathematics, and their children as learners of mathematics? What would you like to leave behind and have them take through the rest of their lives from your course? And how do you make it what you want it to be? When I was in high school, my high school colleagues had a residue that looked like this. This is the sum and substance of high school mathematics. Now, they had no perception that this was going to be useful to them, and so it was really a college entrance process. And as soon as they got into college, with a straight face, we told them to take 5 operations, turn it into 11 operations. Now, surely someone must need to know this, otherwise we can't get people to the moon. For most people, this doesn't make particularly good nonsense. What's at stake here? What's at stake? It's really the second tier. We've got people who are going to be mathematicians no matter what we do. There are a second group of students who are multiply talented, who can do anything they want, who flee from mathematics. And when you ask them why, they say something like, well, in math, the teacher only wants to know whether I remember what Newton or Descartes said. I do, but there's no joy in remembering. I'm thinking with someone else's brain. And in humanities class, the teacher says, what did you think of this? How would you write the last 3 pages of this article? We need to let students use their own brain rather than borrowing someone else's. Particularly in our mathematics class. There's something else that's happening here with the residue. We know that it's not a good idea to teach to the test. But what researchers, great researchers, are finding that there's a problem with learning for the test. The intent the learner has when going into a learning process has everything to do with how they remember and what they remember. Students who are learning for the test, once the test has been passed, their brain does the appropriate thing and purges that information. Those of us who teach students the year after the major 5 of the BC exam are very familiar with this process. I'd like for you to do several thought experiments. The first is, imagine the end of course test is given not at the end of this year, but at the end of next year. If your end of course test isn't given at the end of next year, how would you teach? Would it be different? Would you have them do more drill and practice? Or would you have them engage in developing and incriminating the information of their own active learning? Is that how you would do it? Having them take the course test at the end of the next year means you're honest about what they're experiencing. What you do with mathematics depends upon your belief in mathematics. Poetry is an imaginary garden for real folks. Mathematics is the same thing. It's this duality of theoretical mathematics and applications of mathematics. The magical garden. The real toads. Spend time with the toads. Mathematical modeling is the best way to engage student creativity and have them own the material. It's really, really important to never underestimate the power of the toads. I was once told that although once changed its assembly line, so a group of people went down the line, this 15 people made that car. So the car is still in service 20 years later. They get a bonus in their retirement check. Imagine if we did this with our students. Imagine if you got a bonus every time a student used something you taught them. Would you change what you taught and how you taught it? And if so, what does that mean? Would you get a bonus for this? I mean, you could say, well, that's not the way slope is being tested on the end of the course exam. But it is the way the residue of slope will be tested for the rest of their lives. We need them to recognize the mathematics they're learning in their lives. Testing is fundamental. It determines whether we're successful or not. I'm not sure why. Yep, we believe it. Now, let's think about this normal distribution. If I didn't teach them anything, I would expect a normal distribution. I intend for them to learn. I want everybody to learn, not just a part of my students. One thing always gets better students. These are the best students their parents have, they're not going to give them to them. And no matter what you think about their intellectual capabilities, be sure there's not enough to believe if you don't believe them. So I encourage you, teach mathematics as if your students' futures depend upon it, because it does, and so do ours. And teach it in a way that leaves a residue that will be useful and helpful to them and to all of us. Thank you.